To get ready for our dancing theme, try to recall a dance when you became so engaged with your dancing partner that both of you totally lost awareness of your surroundings. It was just the two of you, and nothing else mattered. Got that image? Well, tonight, our creative directors, Gary Reynolds and Jeff Gerard, have put together a selection of music that may take you to that very moment in time. Maybe you and your partner got passionately lost in a Celtic dance, or maybe it was a slow waltz, or a klezmer celebration. Or how about getting lost with passion in a high-energy polka? Stranger things have happened. Whatever music it was, maybe you'll get to relive that treasured moment in the upcoming arrangements. Tonight's show includes several surprises. To start off, we are being joined by a talented MC from the past. Many of you know her well. She has played in our clarinet section for 14 years and was BandTogether's co-MC for 4 years. She is an awesomely talented lyricist, entertainer, musician, and she is going to introduce our next arrangement. Please help me give a warm welcome and a round of applause to our co-MC for tonight, Dina Young.
Our first number is called El Choclo, and I was given instructions on how to pronounce that by our Spanish teacher in residence, and I'm very thankful to him. Despite its tantalizing name, our next piece, El Choclo, has nothing to do with chocolate. Far from it. El Choclo actually translates into the ear of corn. No one seems entirely sure why this piece is called El Choclo, but one thing is certain. It is one of the most popular Argentine tangos ever written. The piece was published in Buenos Aires by Villoldo in 1903, at a time when the tango was a dance associated with Argentinian brothels and was not danced in polite company, similar to ragtime music was in the United States. When sailors from Argentina sailed into Parisian harbors in the early 1900s, those thankless ambassadors of culture brought the tango with them, and not just into brothels, but into the streets and salons of Paris, where the dance became all the rage in 1913. Women are said to have given up wearing corsets in order to dance the tango, and dress styles changed, becoming more open at the hemline to make it easier for women to move their feet to the new sensuous music. Once the tango became a respectable activity, everyone on both sides of the Atlantic to learn the intricate and intimate style of the dance that many of us know from watching Morticia and Gomez Adams demonstrate on TV. For those of a certain age, El Choclo may sound familiar but recognizable as the Kiss of Fire instead. New English lyrics to the song were written in the 1940s, and Kiss of Fire became a Billboard number one hit in 1952 when Georgia Gibbs recorded it. Over the years, Louis Armstrong, Connie Francis, Nat King Cole, Julio Iglesias, and even Hugh Laurie, the doctor from House, recorded it. Featuring Sean Orlando on trumpet, here is Gary Reynolds leading the band in El Choclo.
Thank you.
Okay, so tell me it's not getting hot in here.